offer the chairman whether you have any regulation, you have any guideline addressed to the private contractor that would prohibit the private contractor from having communications with the political entities directly to him. Is there any prohibition, Mr. Chairman?
I am not aware of any specific prohibition, but I guess
I would suppose there should be some kind of law, Mr. Chairman, because you start talking
to a private company which has dealings with government. And I think there should be some ethical considerations. I think that should be the one that should be expanded. But specifically for purposes of elections, then maybe we can develop the proposal so that it will apply specifically only to cases where automation will be the system used and that the provider, private entity, is insulated. This is something very, very specific. I think there are general...
For example, Mr. Chairman, for example, if Mr. Flores is seen socializing with known political personalities, is there a prohibition? Is he guilty of violating anything already by that very act?
No, I don't think so. That would be... that's his right. He can always socialize if he wants to, but if you come out with a specific law, that he should not be socializing, at least during the election period.
You have selected to be to handle a very sensitive democratic process. It's not a matter of right anymore. You know, the moment you have that kind of a responsibility, you have to forego a certain social rights, Mr. Chairman, to make sure that the entire process is beyond suspicion.
But we're talking of Mr. Flores, who is well known to be socializing. He's not really the technical guy of this one. I think he's actually the PRO or the salesman. The technical people is one, but they are those who do not come out in the open.
You
think
he's being dined by a political group, but there's nothing wrong with that, Mr. Chairman. It's a matter of political, it's a matter of right to this one to accept that kind of an invitation.
I think so, Your Honor, unless there's a law which says he should not, because but during a limited period, because we cannot restrict
The contractual relationship between the public and the private contractor.
Well, we could do so, which means by resolution, when we enter into a contract with the provider, we can limit his activities. We can impose some limitations on him. That is restricting from doing so and so. We want to get the support of a law which choose against this private provider. So that's why we are really happy to see that there is such an insulation of the private provider rather than insulate Comelec private provider. To this we have created. And if we have this law, then we will be able to tell the private provider, you cannot do this, you cannot do that, and we will insert this all in all of our resolutions. All of our contracts and agreements with the private contractor.
May we request also that that point be included insofar as the possible restrictions to the IT or service provider is concerned in your position paper. After all, in the event that there would be a law, it would be the Comelec who should be making the rules and regulations or the restrictions.
No provision which will authorize the government to come out to resolutions restricting the activities of the private contractor.
Thank you very much.
Chairman, maybe better still if we put everything in writing. All communications to the government, to the providers, should be in writing. So there will be no doubt. If it's not in writing, then there's already a suspicion. Should be probably the best way to do it. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
The next item in our agenda is House Bill number 956, authored by Congressman Pedro Romualdo.